Mr. Whitelaw's visit follows the report into the Wormwood Scrubs riot in August 1979, which criticised the then governor and found that some prison staff had been responsible for assaulting inmates. That didn't go down at all well with the prison staff. Although today's visit was officially just part of the Home Secretary's routine, there's little doubt that Mr. Whitelaw was there to boost the warders' flagging morale.
They were perfectly frank with me that they felt that much good work had been done at that time, 2.5 years ago, and that they felt that all the complaints and all the press and everything else concentrated on the mistakes, and nothing was done to praise those who had saved a very dangerous situation. And the fact is, whatever mistakes there may have been, and that's all in the past now, a much good work was done. Many officers were very brave and they felt very much hurt by the criticisms. I can understand that. And then, of course, last week they did an extremely good operation. And I hope it will be widely recognised that that was, in that hostage situation, a very good operation.
The present governor once described this as a penal dustbin, Mr. Whitelaw. Would you agree with that?
Well, having seen it, it is certainly a very unsatisfactory prison. I wouldn't seek to put any gloss on what the governor has said. The governor's competing in these conditions. He has to live in those conditions. They are very difficult conditions. I've done my best nationally and will continue to persuade the British public that we have to spend money on our prisons. I'm going to have the chance of spending more money on our prisons, on new prisons, on maintenance and improvements, than any government has done for a very long time.
Although Mr. Whitelaw's words will have been well received by the prison staff, he did not manage to have any discussions with the prisoners. Colin Baker at Wormwood Scrubs.
If you would care to do the television interviews first.
Could I do them first? Yes, of course I could. That'd be lovely.
Just out in this corner.
Okay, I'll do the television interviews first, and then I'll talk to everybody else afterwards.
Excellent. Mr. Whitelaw, what was the purpose?
Here we go, gentlemen.
We want to get
sorted out. Well, where do you want it?
Just where you are now.
Just with this background.
I want the governor beside me, if I can somewhere. Where do you want me? Show me where you want me.
If you stand exactly there.
There.
Facing this way, life would be perfect.
Okay, this is the governor beside me.
What was it like inside Home Secretary?
First of all, somebody asked me for the purpose of what my
Indeed I did, yes.
I came here as soon as I could after the publication of the report. You will appreciate I much regretted that because of the possibilities of prosecutions and the police inquiries, for over 2 years I was unable to come and speak to the staff. And this has been a period of great uncertainty for them, and great difficulty for morale, and great difficulties for the governor, who has done a magnificent job in overcoming it, and I want to pay a special tribute to Mr. McCarthy for what he has done. This was a very difficult time for everybody to wait. They naturally wanted to express their feelings of frustration and unhappiness to me personally. I knew that, and I came here today for that purpose.
What was the atmosphere like inside the...
They were perfectly frank with me, and I was very frank with them. They were perfectly frank with me that they felt that much good work had been done at that time, 2.5 years ago, and that they felt that all the complaints and all the press and everything else concentrated on the mistakes, and nothing was done to praise those who had saved a very dangerous situation. And the fact is, whatever mistakes there may have been, and that's all in the past now, a much good work was done. Many officers were very brave and they felt very much hurt by the criticisms. I can understand that. And then, of course, last week they did an extremely good operation. And I hope it will be widely recognised that that was, in that hostage situation, a very good operation. And what they feel is that it would be a good thing if, when there is good news from the Wormwood Scrubs prison, it is known to the country at large. And that's why I'm very grateful to be here on the television this afternoon to say that I greatly admire their efforts in a very difficult situation with, like so many of our buildings, very bad buildings. And I'm enormously grateful both to the governor and all his staff for what they have done, and I would like the general public to know it.
The present governor once described this as a penal dustbin, Mr. Whitelaw. Would you agree with that?
Well, having seen it, it is certainly a very unsatisfactory prison. I wouldn't seek to put any gloss on what the governor has said. The governor's competing in these conditions. He has to live in those conditions. They are very difficult conditions. I've done my best nationally and will continue to persuade the British public that we have to spend money on our prisons. I'm going to have the chance of spending more money on our prisons, on new prisons, on maintenance and improvements than any government has done for a very long time. That's very necessary, and I want the nation to know that's happening, and I want the nation to know that prison officers have to work in very bad conditions. Just how many people in our national life would actually be still working, some 60% of our prison officers, in buildings that were built before 1877. Just think of that.
What about the prison conditions that prisoners have to live in, Mr. Whitelaw?
I have every confidence in the governor and his officers. They have to cope with many difficult situations. It will not be their fault if there are any difficulties or any troubles. Of course there may be troubles in our prisons. Don't let's forget that our prisons are coping in very difficult conditions with many very difficult men, with many very troubled characters who other people in other places are not able to cope with. They are coped with in the prison service. That's something the prison service should be proud of. Of course there may be troubles, but they won't be the seeking the governor or his staff, who will cope very well indeed if they arise, and have my fullest confidence.
There was criticism of how the governor and the staff handled the riot, how they coped with the riot that happened a couple of years ago. Are you sure that those particular criticisms wouldn't be evident if a similar riot happened again in the near future?
There were some criticisms, of course. Who in our national life from time to time can't be criticised? Anybody can't? I don't know them. There were some criticisms, but there was much good work, and I think they feel justifiably that much of that good work was clouded in the criticisms. I have every confidence that the lessons from that particular unhappy occasion have been fully learnt, and I have every confidence in the governor and his staff that if they are faced with that sort of situation again, and I hope very much they will not, I am fully confident in them. I told the prison officers this afternoon that I had absolute confidence in them, and I would give them every possible support that I could.
Did you speak to any of the prisoners?
Just passed a time of day with the prisoners, one or two. I didn't have a long conversation with them. I wanted to go for a specific purpose, to see the prison officers. They are the employees of the Home Secretary. I am, in a way, I suppose on behalf of the nation, their boss. They were entitled to express their feelings to me. I wanted to give them that chance. I did. I spent a lot of time doing that. I also wanted to see the building, which I had not been able to see all this time. Again, I did that. So, of course, that's right.
And the general morale of people in the prison, prisoners as well as prison officers.
Well, of course, the first thing is that, as far as the prison officers are concerned, in dealing with troubles, that is a question of training and planning. I will do photography.
Thank you very
much.
And
then I will do anybody else.
Just the newspaper writers
you,
now.
You talked just now about spending more money on the prisons than you've been able to spend before. Does this mean more money than you've already earned?
All right.